Okay, we're going to take what we've learned so far when it comes to inequalities and solving them and graphing them, put it all together, and we'll do four examples to kind of show how we can use all the information and do in one question. So let's take everything we learned and do that. First of all, we have four examples here, and let's start with the first example. We've got, first of all, we're going to solve the example, number one, and so we're going to take and begin by, we want to isolate the x. So we get rid of the 3 and the negative 10, so let's get rid of the 10, the plus or minus first, plus 10 since we're minusing 10 to the opposite, and we got 3x, those are gone, 10's gone, and we got 15. Last step here, I'm going to get rid of 3, so I have to divide by 3 since it's multiplying the x, and I get x is greater than 5. There we go. So I got a number line. I got the algebraic solution. Now let's graph, do a graph solution. So let's take and I'm going to circle what? I'm going to circle the, well, let's put a, the 1, 2. Let's start somewhere in the middle here, put a 5. Number's going up. Number's going down. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put a circle at the 5. It's the number in our solution. It's hollow, because there's no equal sign underneath that. I just look at that thing, no equal sign, so I put a hollow. And I'm going to take and the arrow is going to go to the right, that's the way the arrow is pointing, and I put the same shape on the end of that line, and there we are. We've solved and graphed the first question. Second question. Same idea, so let's just go ahead and do this one. I'm going to minus 6 to get rid of it, minus 6. Got negative x, this is gone, it's bigger than negative 9, negative 3 minus 6 more is negative 9, and now I got to give that negative sign, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to divide by negative 1, so negative's gone, it gives me x, negative 9 divided by negative 1 is positive 9, but wait a minute, I just divided by a negative number, remember the special rule, if you divide or multiply the whole equation by a negative, then you have to switch the sign around so it goes this way. So that's our solution. Don't forget to switch it around if it's a negative. And now I'm going to start with 9. So let's put a 9 here. 10, 11, 12. Okay, and then we go down. Okay, so here we're going to do, we're going to put a circle at the 9. It's an empty circle because there's no line under it there. And it's going to go to the left, because that's the way the arrow's pointing in my symbol. It's pointing to the left, so I go to the left, put an arrow on that. Number 2 is done. Okay, go back here, and go down. Okay, a little bit more to this one. So let's, first of all, get all the x's on the same side. So let's get the 2x over to the left side of it. I need the x's on the left-hand side for this. It's important I do that. So I move the x's. It's a positive 2x, so I subtract 2x. I get 3x plus 2. It's bigger than or equal to negative 4. Okay, so now we're going to get rid of the 2. 3x. Bigger than or equal to negative 6. And lastly, positive number I'm dividing by, so I leave the symbol the same. The 3's are gone, just like the 2's were gone in the question before. And I get negative 2. And there we go. Okay, how do I graph this? Well, I put a negative 2 somewhere in the middle here. Let's just put it right, right here. So negative 1, 0, 1. Remember, it gets smaller going to the left. Now I'm going to circle. So let's get a, let's just take this and circle the negative 2. And, oh, there's a line underneath this thing. So I'm going to color that in. Solid. So it shows me that negative 2 is part of the answer. Doesn't exclude it. It's included in the answer. Okay. I'm going to draw an arrow. Which way I'm going to draw the arrow to the... well, look at the arrow's going that way. So I'm going to draw it that way, to the right. And there it is. That's my answer. Okay, one more question. Really quickly here. Get rid of the bracket. There we go. And now let's call the X's on the left-hand side. So let's remove those X's that are on the right-hand side. There we go. And that's gone. That's why we did that, to eliminate that on the right-hand side. Okay. Now we're going to take and get rid of that. 2 right there, plus minus 2 with a plus 2, and that's negative 4. And now we're going to get the x by itself by removing that negative 2, so I divide by negative 2. Okay, and the 2's are gone. X, this becomes 2, and this symbol flips. Why does it flip? Because we just divided by a negative number. There we go. So let's put the numbers on our, put a 2, and we'll go down the other way. Okay, so we're going to circle. Okay, so we're going to circle. We're going to circle the 2, and we notice that the circle is going to be filled in because there's a line underneath there. So let's fill that in. Let's just take this one and fill that in as best we can here. So it looks like it's kind of solid. Okay, and now we're going to draw an arrow. Which way is the arrow going to go? Well, let's look at our thing there. It's going to the right, so I'm going to draw this to the right. Put an arrow on the end there, just like that. And there we go. Finished.